Dear students, welcome to the video lecture series. In this series, today we are learning field effect transistors. This presentation is created and narrated by Hemant Satpute, teacher, Department of Electronic Science, Fergusson College, Junior Wing, Pune. All the contents presented in this presentation is taken from the textbook Basic Electronics and Linear Circuits, written by N.N. Bhargava, D.C. Kulshreshtha and S.C. Gupta. In lecture number 1, we had learned introduction of FET, advantages of FET over vacuum tubes, advantages of FET over BJT, and difference in FET and BJT. Now in lecture number 2, that is in today's lecture, you will be learning structure of junction field effect transistor JFET, symbol of N-channel JFET, and working of N-channel JFET. So let's begin. Structure of a junction field effect transistor JFET. A JFET can be of N-channel type or of P-channel type. The meaning of channel will be made clear later in this section. We shall describe the structure of an N-channel JFET. The structure of a P-channel JFET is similar to that of N-channel JFET, except that in its structure, N-type is replaced by P-type and P-type by N-type. In its simplest form, the structure of an N-channel JFET starts with nothing more than a bar of N-type silicon. This bar behaves like a resistor between its two terminals called source and drain, S and D. We introduced heavily doped P-type regions on either side of the bar. These P regions are called gates. Look in figure B. Usually, the two gates are connected together as shown in figure C. So, the gate terminal is analogous to the base of BJT. So, this is used to control the current flow from the source to drain. Thus, source and drain terminals are analogous to emitter and collector terminals respectively of a BJT. So, in fact, source is analogous to emitter, drain is analogous to collector, and gate is analogous to base. Now, in figure D, the bar of JFET has been placed vertically. The circuit symbol of N-channel JFET is shown in figure 5.36E. Note that the arrow is put in the gate terminal and not in the source terminal, though source is analogous to emitter in BJT. So the gate arrow points into the JFET. In a P-channel JFET, the gate arrow would point out of the JFET. Now here, there will be some small crucial difference between BJT and FET. In BJT, we mark the arrow on the emitter lead, but in JFET, we mark the arrow on the gate lead. Also, the direction of arrow is into the terminal for N-channel JFET, and the direction of arrow is out of the terminal for P-channel JFET. Let us now study why N-type bar is called as a channel. Normally, we operate an N-channel JFET by applying a positive voltage to the drain with respect to the source, as shown in figure 5.37A. So, we apply between drain to source a positive voltage known as VDD. Due to this voltage, the majority charge carriers in the bar, electrons in this case, they start flowing from source to drain. Right now, gate is not given any potential. This flow of electrons makes the drain current ID. So, the current ID is analogous to the collector current IC in BJT. The electrons in the bar have to pass through the space between two P regions. As we shall see, the width of this space between P regions can be controlled by varying the gate voltage. That is why this space is called as a channel. This space is called as a channel because the majority charge carrier, they flow through the space between these the space is called as a channel, because majority charge carrier, that is electron, they flow through the space between two p regions. Now, to see how the width of channel changes by varying the gate voltage, let's consider figure 5.37b. Here we have applied a small reverse bias to the gate using this VGG. Because of this reverse bias, the width of depletion region increases. Since the n-type bar is lightly doped compared to p regions, the depletion region extends more into n-type bar. This reduces the width of the channel. Recall that the depletion regions do not contain any charge carriers. The electrons have to pass through the channel of reduced width. Reduction in the width of the channel, that conducting portion of the bar, increases its resistance. So this reduces the drain current ID. See figure 5.37b very carefully. There is one important point about the channel shape. It is narrower at the drain end. This happens because the amount of reverse bias is not same throughout the length of PN junction. When current flows through the bar, a potential drop occurs across its length. As a result, the reverse bias between the gate and the drain end of the bar is more than that between the gate and the source end of the bar. So the width of the depletion region is more at the drain end than at the source end. As a result, the channel becomes narrower at the drain end. Let us see what happens if the reverse gate bias is increased further. The channel becomes narrower and at the drain end, and the drain current further reduces. If the reverse bias is made sufficiently large, the depletion regions will extend into the channel and meet. This pinches off all the current flow. So the gate to source voltage at which the pinch off occurs is called pinch off voltage, VP. You may think that the channel completely closes at the drain end when the gate to source voltage reaches the pinch off value. But in practice, it does not happen, simply because it cannot happen. Suppose if it were possible, then the channel completely closes at the drain end. The drain end would then reduce to zero. The drain current would then reduce to zero. As a result, there would be no voltage drop across the length of the channel. So amount of reverse bias would become uniformly same throughout the length. The voltage shaped depletion region, the wedge shaped depletion region would try to become straight, that is rectangular shaped. So channel would then open at drain end, so drain current flows. When the gate to source voltage reaches the pinch off value, the channel width reduces to a constant minimum value, so drain current flows through this constricted channel. So this is the end of today's lecture. Stay tuned for the next lecture in the series.